Solve each equation, check the answer. 6x plus 18 is equal to 4x plus 30. Notice how both sides of the equation are simplified in that there are no grouping symbols to remove and there are no common factors. But notice also that there are variable terms on both sides of the equation. We have a 6x and a 4x. So what we want to do is get all the variable terms to one side of the equation. And so what I will do is remove the variable term from the left, from the right-hand side. So I will remove the 4x by subtracting 4x. Now I must remove that same quantity from the left-hand side. And now simplifying the like terms on the left-hand side, I have 2x plus 18 is equal to 30. And now, like before, I identify the variable term and I isolate it. I will subtract 18 from both sides, yielding 2x is equal to 12. And then I will divide both sides by 2 to isolate the variable, yielding x equals 6. We are asked to check the answer, so let's substitute. Is 6 times 6 plus 18 equal to 4 times 6 plus 30. Following the order of operations agreement, we have 36 plus 18, which is 54. And on the right-hand side, we have 24 plus 30, which is 54. So that does check out. And so then the solution is x equals 6. Exercise B. 5 times the quantity 2p minus 9 is equal to 8p minus 10 minus 5p. So the first thing we're going to do is simplify both sides. Alright, so on the left-hand side I can apply the distributive property. So I have 5 times 2p, that's 10p, minus 5 times 9 is 45. On the right-hand side, I have some like terms. I have an 8p and a minus 5p, so that's 3p minus 10. And now, like before, I notice that there are like terms, not like terms, but I notice that there are variable terms on both sides of the equation. So I want to remove the variable term from one side. I'll subtract 3p and do the same thing to the right-hand, to the left-hand side, yielding 7p minus 45 is equal to negative 10. Identify the single variable term and isolate it by adding 45 to both sides, yielding 7p is equal to 35. And we'll isolate the variable by dividing through by 7. And so then p is equal to 5. Let's check that answer. 5 times the quantity 2 by 5 minus 9, is that equal to 8 times 5 minus 10 minus 5 times 5. Following the order of operations agreement on the left, I'd have 5 times 10 minus 9, and so that's 5 times 1, which is 5. On the right hand side, I'd have 40 minus 10 minus 25, and so that's 30 minus 25, which is also 5. And so then that, since that checks out, we do get p is 5. Point 4 by 6n minus 8 plus 0.3n is equal to 6.2n minus 21.4. Alright, so let's simplify on the left-hand side. Applying the distributive property, we have 2.4n minus 3.2 plus 0.3n is still equal to 6.2n minus 21.4. I still have some like terms on the left-hand side. 2.4n plus 0.3n, that is 2.7n. Minus 3.2 is equal to 6.2n minus 21.4. I see that there are variable terms on both sides of the equation. Again, I like to move the variable terms to the left when I'm solving these types of equations. So I will subtract 6.2n from both sides, yielding negative 3.5n minus 3.2 is equal to negative 21.4. Identify the variable term. Isolate it by adding 3.2 to both sides. That yields negative 3.5n is equal to negative 18.2. Then I will isolate the variable by dividing through by negative 3.5. So with a little bit of arithmetic here, we find that n is equal to 5.2. Alright, so let's check that work. See, 0.4 by 6 times 5.2 minus 8 plus 0.3n, so 0.3 times 5.2. Is this equal to 6.2 by 5.2 minus 21.4. All right, order of operations on the left-hand side, working from the inside out in the grouping, we'd have 0.4. Now 6 times 5.2 is 31.2 minus 8. Now let's see, plus 0.3 by 5.2. Still following the order of operations, dealing with that subtraction, we'd have 0.4 by 23.2 plus 0.3 by 5.2. 0.4 times 23.2 is 9.28. 0.3 times 5.2 is 1.56. And finally adding, let's see, 8 plus 6 is a 14, carrying a 1, 10.84. Now let's check the right-hand side. On the right-hand side, 6.2 times 5.2 is 32.24, and subtracting 21.4 does give us 10.84. So that checks out, and so the solution is n equals 5.2.